Alopecia areata is an autoimmune condition and usually presents as patchy hair loss. It can affect any hair on the body, so it may affect the scalp hair, which is the most common presentation, but can also affect the beard, body hair, eyebrows, or eyelashes. Alopecia areata can also present as dramatic diffuse hair thinning or hair loss from the scalp or body. Alopecia areata can occur in men and women or children of any age and can be a chronic relapsing condition. Alopecia areata is caused by the body's own white blood cells attacking the hair follicle. This is therefore an autoimmune condition. The inflammatory process does not cause permanent damage to the hair follicles, and so they are able to regenerate and regrow hair. Alopecia areata is usually painless and presents as patches of hair loss on the scalp. Occasionally, however, people may say that their scalp feels sore or itchy, or may be able to predict where their next patch may occur. When the dermatologist examines the scalp of a patient with alopecia areata, hair follicles can be visible. However, the scalp sometimes has a mild salmon pink colour where the patches of hair loss are. We think that there is a genetic predisposition for people with alopecia areata, but we also know that occasionally environmental factors can play a role as well. The most common precipitant that we see is stress. Sometimes treatment is not required for alopecia areata when the patches are very small, as spontaneous regrowth can occur. When dermatologists treat alopecia areata, the degree of hair loss needs to be taken into consideration, as well as the age of the patient. When treating children, we may use a topical steroid lotion on the scalp to reduce inflammation and allow the hair follicle to regenerate and regrow hair. When treating adults, we often use intralesional triamcinolone, which is a steroid injection, directly into the patches of hair loss. Once again, this has an anti-inflammatory effect and allows the hair follicle to recover. When hair loss from alopecia areata is more extensive, a specialist type of treatment can be the use of topical immunotherapy, or DCP, applied directly to the scalp. Another form of treatment for extensive alopecia areata is the use of immunosuppressing systemic medication. This medication does need to be prescribed by a specialist and does need to be under close supervision. PRP, or platelet-rich plasma, is another experimental form of treatment which has shown some early promise. Two exciting breakthroughs have occurred with the JAK inhibitors, a new class of medication which has shown some early promise for the treatment of severe alopecia areata. These treatments are not yet commercially available, but further research is ongoing.